Welcome, I'm Dex, and this is the Whips in the Dungeon channel. The channel's primarily focused on whips. If you're interested in leather and have a broader interest in varying aspects of leather and BDSM, then I encourage you to watch my other channel, The Leather Journey. But in a channel that's interested in whips, how do we transport these whips around? I mean, we need to do it discreetly because of public rules of conduct, and most private parties don't necessarily want to advertise to their neighbors, or the vanillas certainly don't want to alert authorities as to what might or might not be going on in their home or in a venue. So transporting to and from a venue with discretion for any type of toy, but certainly a whip. How do we do that? Well, I've got a couple of whip bags I'm gonna show you today. And I wish I could show you one that I knew you were gonna be able to find. This is a Duluth Trading Post bag that I got from Duluth Trading Post years ago. And originally it was designed to carry a pneumatic wrench for like construction workers. But when I looked at this bag, the shape of this bag, it had a nice circular area on this end, and it kind of came down into a nose or a point. And me being a whip thrower, I visualized, well, the bullwhip handle can go here and the whip itself can be coiled on this end of the bag, and it's not overly big. I could carry 3 or 4 whips in here discreetly, and people that see it are going to say, oh, he's carrying a tool bag, because that's what it originally was. It was a tool bag. So as I got into two-hand whips, carrying twice as many whips around and not having them overly tightly coiled became a little bit problematic with this type of bag. So I found another bag that I like that I'm going to share with you. And these, by all means, aren't the only ways to carry whips around. This is the way Dex carries this whips around. This is a portfolio bag that an artist might use to carry a canvas. I think I bought it at Staples or Office Max. And it has 2 zippers that zip down the sides. And all I will say about this bag is it works nicely to carry my two-hand bullwhips, my two-hand dragon tails, 2 of anything, 2 floggers, 2 whatever I'm throwing. This works nicely. I will say, if you source a bag like this, before you buy it and take it home, check the zippers and see how they work, because I'll tell you, this one has a double zipper. It zips this way, zips this way, and the flaw of this particular bag is if I zip it too far down the side, the zipper's made so that it's very difficult to zip it back up. So I've actually taken a piece of duct tape and I duct taped over the lower part of that zipper on both sides, so in a dimlit dungeon I wouldn't accidentally zip it too far and then not be able to get it zipped back up. But I can zip it halfway down either side. It works nicely. People seeing me carry this are gonna think I'm carrying a portfolio, or I'm like oil painting, I'm an artist and I'm carrying some canvases around. So I can discreetly go to or from an event with either one of these bags and not cause undue attention. I've seen all different types of cases, all the way from rolling suitcases to people using golf club bags. The soft guitar cases seem to make nice toy bags. So whatever toy bag you settle on, think about what toys you're gonna be carrying in it and what is it going to work and not cause undue attention. Like, to be honest, a rifle case works nicely as a cane case, but I don't know that I would wanna be walking into an event carrying a case that looks like it might have an AK-47 inside it. So that's an instance where the case might cause undue attention in a different way than what, you know, you're worried about. So find something that's discreet, that's commonly seen in the vanilla scene, that's not going to cause undue attention as you're going to and from a venue. But those are two examples of what I use for whip bags. As always, thanks for watching Whips in the Dungeon.